like to say this hot, but you know, the earth was without AC for thousands of years. I don't know how they did it, y'all, but somehow they did it. They didn't know what they were missing, that's all I can say. But anyway, God is still good, and he's here. Like I said, we're believing God that he'll be back, come back home this morning, this afternoon. I was just joking that. Those of y'all that came in a little bit later, storm, I guess, one of these last few storms that came in and blew up, actually the cover for one of the panels off. So the power company came by and saw it off and turned off for power for safety purposes. And so we came and saw it, and they said that we had y'all to see and stuff. So we're in that process, but you know what? God's good, and his mercy endures forever. So, but I do want to say this. We had a nurse, a couple of nurses that were here from the wrong office. They might be out there, but representing the hospitals, they have a lot of the hospitals have been just full, completely packed. There have been different times throughout the coronavirus and the different seasons, even in this last couple months. And so we pray in protection over them, for protection, grace over them, people to be able to get rooms. For some of y'all, I know, in case of people, my brother-in-law, like there's zero rooms, and we prayed all of a sudden there was rooms that were available for them to go to the emergency room. So we're just praying, and we believe God for angels. We're actually going to be talking about that behind the scenes, angels,
yes.
You know, our spirit, God's spirit. So those things are real. We pray for them, and let's just pray right now. Lord, I thank you for a special anointing and grace over all the doctors and nurses, Lord, and hospital workers. Lord, as they go through this, Lord, they're fighting for us on our behalf, Lord. I thank you, Lord God, that you're the great physician, but you also, you know, and you use the hands of men and women, Lord Jesus, and you can use them. I pray that you will protect them,
yes,
Father
God.
And even more than that, give them wisdom, Father, as they serve people and they serve us, give them great wisdom. You are the great physician, Lord Jesus. And I thank you most of all for salvation in Jesus' name. Everybody say
amen.
Praise God. Well, it's so good to say everybody. Listen, I'm going to try to keep it as short, as sweet as possible. Praise the Lord this morning. But we are starting anew. I'm going to try to be as loud as I can, but just bear with me. But we're starting a new series on, it's called Behind the Scenes. How many of y'all know that there is more than meets the eye with this world?
Amen.
You believe that? Now the world says, hey, if I don't see it, I won't believe it. Has anybody ever said that? I've said it. I mean, we've all said it. If you show me the money, come on, turn it into show me the money. Show me the money. Okay, I'm gonna say it like, oh, I don't know. Turn it in and say, show me the money. In other words, all this talk that I got to see it to believe it. And that's the way this world operates. You show me, and then I will believe it. That's not the way God operates. God says this. It says in 2 Corinthians 5:7, it says, for we walk by faith and not by sight. Now, that sight right there is talking about physical sight. There you are, my son. That was looking for me to pray for you there. Yeah, that's all right. You moved on. One of our nurses got it. We walk by faith. I should have been walking my spiritual system there. But we walk by faith and not by sight. The world says, show me, prove to me there's a God. You might have heard that. If you show me, I will believe. You know, when the Bible says that Lazarus and the rich man, Abraham said, you come back to them, they're not going to believe. Because they have to accept Jesus for their heart to be in the right position. So really, in all honesty, that is still a lie. But that is what this world says. You prove to me, you show me, then I will believe. But God says, believe, and then I will show you.
Yeah.
I'm going to say that one more time. The world says, show me the money. Show me. Prove to me, then I will believe. God says, that's not how it works. God says, you believe, and then I will show you. What did he tell Moses? Oh, Mo. He had that stick in his hand. Mo couldn't even talk. He stuttered. He gave God a list of mile long of his excuses. Has anybody ever done that? God says, do this. God, I can't, because. And God ignores that and says, I thought you to go. And so Moses went, delivered the people. He goes to the Red Sea, and all he sees is a Red Sea. He got his back against the wall. Pharaoh's army's coming down hard, coming in hot, you know, just boom right there. And God over the sea.
Yes.
And Moses said, why am I going to do that? I don't see anything. It's a bad situation. But God required Moses to believe.
Yes.
And then he showed him something.
Yes.
He showed him the salvation of the children of God. And so, I mean, Moses had to walk by faith. I mean, God, he had to walk by faith, not by sight. Anybody ever done something in much fear and trembling? Anybody ever done that? God said, did that first time. Everybody gonna think I'm whacked out. I'm so crazy already. How many of y'all guys had to go start that business? Oh, but I can't. I'm too young. I'm too this. I'm too that. Anybody ever been there? But you did it anyway with much fear and trembling. Anybody ever done that before?
Yes.
I'm only one group. We set out to start a church in Cypress, Texas with much fear and trembling. Didn't know one person in this whole area. But yet, God says, spread your rod over the sea. And Moses is like, I can't see anything. This doesn't make sense. This is not a battle plan. 2 + 2 doesn't equal this. This does not make sense. But God says, open up, listen, your spiritual eyes. And
good.
Just lift that stick that you got in your hand, open
good.
The sea, and then watch me. You don't have to call the waves. You don't have to speak to the waves. You don't
that's
have to
good.
Do nothing. All you have to do is believe and do what I say.
Yeah.
Put that stick over the water.
That's good.
Yes. And he did. And he was walking because he walked not by faith. I mean, not by sight, but by faith. And so this world says, show me that I will believe. God says, believe and trust me. I will show you. And never once has he let us down. Sometimes he doesn't do it on our time frame. But listen, how many of y'all believe that Moses thought, hey, God, once we get out of here, we're out of here. We're never going to deal with Pharaoh again. We're just going to be cloud nine floating through for a couple of weeks to the promised land. Everything's smooth sailing. But how many of y'all know that's not how it went down?
No.
Is that right? That's not how it went. They had Pharaoh's army, you know, coming at them, and then they had to go to the Red Sea, they had rebellion, and had, you know, God had to wipe out all these rebellious people, and had to go through all this one around 40 years. But yet, was God wrong?
No.
Was he an unjust God? Was he not real? No. Listen, God's plan was different than Moses' plan.
Yeah.
That's why God said, you just believe. It's my job to make it happen. It's your job to believe. But what if, God says, there's no if in me. There's no if. There's something working behind the scenes.
Yeah.
In 2 Kings, if you have a Bible, you can. I was a little dark in here. But I'm just going to read through 2 Kings 6, verse 17 says, and Elisha prayed and said, Lord, I pray thee, open his eyes that he may see. Everybody say, open my eyes that I may see. Open my eyes that I may see. Elisha prayed, and that's my prayer today for the church, for myself. God, open my eyes that I can see.
That's good.
What about the Red Sea? God says, open your eyes. I'll pray, open my eyes so I can see past the Red Sea. What about this? What about that? What about my family? What about the finances? What about the coronavirus? What about the hurricane? What about this? God, listen, my prayer is like Elisha. He saw in the spirit as a prophet. He told his servant, his Padawan friend, you know, his dude that was in training. He said, check this out. God, open his eyes that he may see for real.
Yeah. Yeah.
Because what we see now is just two-dimensional.
That's right.
What we see now is just part of it.
Yeah.
The spirit world was here way before, and no one knows there's no beginning of God. There's no end. We can't understand that because we live in this thing called time, but God does not.
Yeah.
And so Elisha said, he prayed to God, Lord, I pray thee, open his eyes that he may see. And the Lord opened the eyes of the young man, and he saw, and behold, the mountains were full of horses and chariots and fire round about Elisha.
Wow. Yeah. Yes.
Elisha. Okay? He opened his eyes. What was he seeing? He saw behind the scenes.
Yeah.
What was that? The spirit world. The spirit world was here before God said, let there be light. There
That's
was the
good.
Spirit world. God is spirit. We're going to go into that even next week. We're going to talk about the Trinity a little bit, talk about the Holy Spirit, which is here with us today. But there is something more than this world that we live in.
Yeah.
It is the spirit world. And it was here before this world began. It will be here after this world ends.
Listen,
this world has a, it's like a sand, like a little sand thing you turn. There will be a day where the time for this world has run out.
Yeah.
And the Bible says that he will fold the cosmos up like a towel. Anybody fold a towel?
Yeah.
Anybody fold a towel? He's just bam, bam, bam. Can you imagine God taking the cosmos? I'm not talking about one world. I'm not talking about just our solar system. I'm not talking about our galaxy. I'm not even talking about our universe. I'm not even, that's why I come up with something that's like a group of universes. I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about everything in existence. Everything. And what is going to take it to fold it up? It's going to fold it up. And here we're all worried about, you know, our bank account or, you know, our, you know, the coronavirus or something so temporal. But God, listen, he will fold it all up.
That's
he
good.
Is. God said, I can't even explain who I am to you. So what did he give to Moses? And Moses said, who are you, Lord? I mean, I know you're God, but like, how did you come? What is this? How are you? Like, who are you? And God said, I can't explain and reveal everything to you because you can't understand. But I am. Just go with that. I am that I am. In other words, there's so much more behind the scene, Moses, than is to me.
That's
but just
good.
Know that I'm here and
that's
I'm for you.
Yeah. Yeah.
I'm here and I'm for you. I'm here and I'm for you. And God says, I am that I am. And so Moses was able to look into the spirit realm. Elisha was able to see into the spirit realm. And now sometimes God may give you a vision. We actually see into the spirit realm. Sometimes, you know, there's demonic activity and angelic activity. We're not afraid because God has not given us a spirit of fear, but power of love, and a sound mind.
Right.
How can I have power of love, and a sound mind in the midst of craziness? Because I have God on my side.
Yes.
How can I not, as a child of God, how can I not have a spirit of power, love, and a sound mind and courage? How can
That's
I not when I know that God is
That's
on my
right.
side?
Yeah.
Living behind
yeah.
me.
Yeah.
So Elisha, I don't even know if Elisha had a vision and it saw a chariot of fire, or did you, he just knew? I don't know who the Bible is. He was a prophet, so you know God would show visions and things, and so that would line up. But nothing said that he saw it before then, but he knew that it existed. And so he just said, God, open his eyes. I don't know if God opened Elisha's eyes before. He just said it in faith because he knew that God was on his side. But when he opened the eyes in the spirit realm, listen, in the natural, the eyes saw were surrounded by the enemy.
Yes.
Y'all know the story because the whole army came against Elisha because God was showing Elisha the enemy's plans, and he would go tell Israel's general, and they would, you know, counteract, and the Assyria would never be able to come against them. And so it's like, who is in my camp? It is a traitor.
Yeah.
We're about to take this mole out. You know, what's it? And they said, no. It's not a traitor. It's a man of God that sees you in your prayer chamber.
That's right.
And sees the plans that we write out because
that's
there's
right.
God.
Yeah.
And we know this. And so they didn't send the armies against Israel. They sent it against Elisha. And this is Elisha. And they surrounded the city. But they weren't even surrounding the city. They were surrounding to get one man. And so word came to Elisha, the servant said, Elisha, they after you go there after us. Oh my goodness, what are we going to do? They sent the cavalry. They sent the National Guard. Everything is around us. And I believe the spirit of God rose up inside of them. You know, in the Old Testament, the spirit would anoint the prophets and give them visions and give them things. They didn't have the spirit of God living inside them as we do after we Acts, okay. But I believe that the Spirit of God showed him and gave him a spirit of faith to open his eyes. And Elisha said, listen, there's a lot more with us than there are with them. I'm serious. Like, one, two, and then counting the armies like, okay, something wrong with this man, y'all. He's got one too many locusts or something. I don't know. He got a bad man's locusts. Because there's a whole lot more with them. But then God opened his eyes. Was he imagining things?
Yeah.
Was it a dream? Was it a daydream? No, it was, are y'all ready for this? It was reality.
That's right.
Yeah.
Y'all ready for that? What Elijah saw and showed his servant was not a vision, was not a prophetic vision, something. It was the reality of the situation.
That's so good. Yes.
It was what is more real. And this is what I'm here to say. I'm just going to say a couple more, so much more stuff. I'm quick about series one. I'll say that I'm going to read a couple more scriptures. But what is in the spirit was here before what we see.
Yeah.
And it is more real. It's like the third dimension. God lives in the spirit realm. Now he sent Jesus. Jesus put on flesh and walked into time in the natural realm.
Yeah.
And now Jesus can go from the natural to the spirit. Once he's a man, he didn't go back in. And now he doesn't have a body and he's just a spirit. No. Once he, and Satan understood this, once Jesus became a man, he was always a man.
Yeah. Yes.
Never would he go back to only being the spirit. But understand that he stepped out of time into the natural realm, but then he went back and with a glorified body, with a glorified body back to the throne room of heaven to the right hand of the Father. But he is, and heaven is, and the Father is in the spirit realm. In other words, there is a world that was before this world that cannot be seen with the natural eye, but can only be seen in the spiritual eyes of faith. Somebody say eyes of faith.
Eyes of faith.
So whenever Paul said in 2 Corinthians 5:7, we walk by faith and not by sight. He was saying that we have to open our eyes and realize there is more for us than there are for them.
Yeah.
That's how we can have a spirit of faith, power, love, and a sound mind.
Yeah.
Because there's more behind the scenes.
Yeah.
Listen, I'm not one of those that says, well, everything's the devil. You know, that person's that bad. It must be the devil. God and Satan, Satan and his demons, they can do a lot of stuff. But everything bad that happens, the devil's not that good. I'll just say that. He is bad. I know my English is not correct, but everything wrong that happens is not Satan. Sometimes it's our own decision-making process.
Right. Yes.
If I get mad and I punch a hole through the wall or something like that, and we say, oh, that devil, I can't believe me. No, that child just lost the temper. That's all that happened. Now, he might throw the fire dart or, say, hey, think of this, but we took it and we did it. And sometimes it's just our whole thing. So I'm not one to say that everything that bad that happens is Satan, but he is alive and well and working. And so when something comes against us, we have to learn, and we're going to talk about this, I think, week three or four, is we have to learn how to war in the heavens.
Yes.
The Bible says that our weapons are not carnal in the flesh, but they're mighty through God and pulling down the stronghold. In other words, when something bad is happening, it might be more than meets the eye, like Transformers, right here. It might be more than what you see, and we need to step over like Elisha did and look into the spirit and start to proclaim things. And start to pray over the situation.
Yes.
And start to be bold in that, because there is more than meets the eye. That's why we walk by faith. Has anybody ever been praying for something or somebody, and you just felt a little tug at, I just feel like praying for this in their life.
Yes.
You start praying, and just start praying. And whenever we pray on the street, so many times, a lot of people are like, oh, I need prayer. Are you sure? Would you just allow me the honor of praying for you? Oh, okay. Many times I say, no, I have that. I'm everything good. Would you just allow me to pray? Would you give me the honor of praying for you some blessings? 99.5% of the time, they'll say, oh, okay. Sometimes they don't. That's all right. I'll pray for when I leave. This is a prayer. But when you start praying, and when you've not done that, maybe you're praying for a brother or sister or somebody, you start praying, and then your spirit, you feel, I should pray for their brother. I need to pray for their daughter, son. And maybe you feel that your spirit person, man, inside of you, that is literally seeing into the spirit realm. And you don't all the time connect with it in your mind. Like, oh, okay, there's a vision. This is exactly what you need. Sometimes God can show us. But sometimes it's just like a hunch. that person looks super sad. Like, man, they even almost look like they might be wanting to commit suicide. I don't know. And your spirit, man, is leading and screaming at you. You go, and then it's just like a little nudge that is behind the scenes. Those people may be tormented demonically, and this might be the last day that they're going to be on earth. And inside your spirit, man, and there's something going on and out that you cannot see with your physical eyes. There's something going on behind the scenes. What's up, Miss Roger? There's something going on behind the scenes. And I just want to admonish you. Listen, Satan will always make you feel like you are less than, and you're not good enough. And your situations are always just because of you're bad or whatever. And sometimes there are things that are happening because of our not smart actions. Sometimes we go through things because we did something wrong. But there's many times we're going through something because we did something right. And if you're going through something because you did something right, there is a spiritual opposition.
That's right.
That it just, you cannot see with your eyes.
That's good.
And that's what I want to go behind the scenes. And I want to tell you that there is more for us than there is for them. Somebody say, open my eyes.
Open my eyes.
We see in the spirit world, and I'm going to say this, four things, and I'm going to close here in 5 minutes, y'all. Four things about the spiritual world. Number one, it's unseen. In the unseen, we receive our sight. In the unseen, we receive our sight to see.
That's so good.
Remember, God said, the world says, show me and I'll believe. God says, believe and I'll show you. Believe, and then I will give you the sight to see.
Yeah.
In the unseen realm, when we worship, when we read, when we cry out to God, when we devote our life and say, God, I don't even know what you want for my life, but whatever it is, that's what I want.
Yeah.
When we do that in the unseen, then God starts to give us sight to see how to pray, what to do, what job to take, who to marry. That would be single people. Who to marry.
Yeah.
Come on, so y'all should shout or something.
Yeah.
God will show you beyond the fluff, beyond the makeup, beyond the Instagram, beyond the whatever you want to see on whatever all those dating sites are. I know what they're called. Listen, beyond all of that, you can see into the spirit realm with your spirit and say, that's not for me. Not today, Satan. Somebody say, not today,
Satan.
In the unseen, we receive the sight to see.
Yes.
We're going to talk about spiritual worship.
Amen.
We're going to talk about spiritual warfare. We're going to talk about a relationship with the Holy Spirit. Okay? But the spirit world is unseen. In the unseen, we receive our sight to see. 2 Corinthians 4:18. While we look not on the things which are seen, but at the things which are not seen, for the things which are seen are temporal. Because it's always going to go away. God's going to fold it up in a towel. But the things which are not seen are eternal. Boom, I love that.
Amen.
Same thing about the spirit realm is it is where God lives.
Yes.
It's God's realm.
Yes.
Listen, I want to play on God's turf.
Yeah.
Yes.
This right here, this is Satan's turf. Now, I'm a man of faith. We should. We don't need to proclaim that. No, listen, Satan is the God of this world.
Yes.
Small people. But my citizenship is not of this world.
That's
I'm
right.
In this world, but not of it. And listen, Adam gave Satan the when he sinned, but Jesus took those keys back.
Yeah.
Whenever he died on the cross, gave them to us. Now, wherever my foot goes, I have dominion. I am the child of God. Satan has no right over me. Now, he has the right over everything else in this world but the children of God.
Amen.
At least that's what my Bible tells me.
That's right.
And so, but the spirit realm, whenever you can pray and worship and see, then we're in God's turf. And
that's right.
Yes.
I said we win every time.
Yes.
I said we win every time.
Yes.
I said we win every time. If I know that my home turf and home field advantage where I'm supposed to be fighting this battle in this war is in the spirit, why am I trying to do it in the natural?
That's so good.
And we wrestle not against flesh and blood. But against the rulers, authorities, and power, principalities, powers that are in the darkness. Okay, I'm about to read that. I was actually putting NIV and King James together there. But listen, we know more. But when we try to do things on our own, and we try to do things in the natural, and we're trying to do things without God's help, then we're going to lose every time. Even when we win, we lose. Because when somebody wins without God, it's not really success. It's not. When someone wins without God, it is not success. Remember, we talked about this a couple years ago. The Bible defines good success. So if there's good success, obviously there's bad success. But real success is in the spirit when we do things with God. And listen, if we don't, and we have fear, or we have self-reliance, or whatever it is, we will fall.
That's right.
But when we heavily rely on God and what He's doing in the unseen realm, then we will win. Somebody say, we win.
We win.
So the unseen world, the spirit world is unseen. It's where God lives. There's a lot more I can say about that, but I'm going to wrap this up. And then it is where the power is.
Yeah.
Spirit realm is where the power is. Listen, we can be Mr. Universe. We can be Bill Gates. And listen, there's nothing wrong with those things. And you can use any platform to preach the gospel. I mean, you know, any godly platform that you're not going against what's in the Word of God. But you can use football. You can use bodybuilding. You can use a politician, a doctor, a lawyer, a father, a mother. You use those things. But understand that if you want to make a difference, an eternal difference in someone's life, you have to step into the spiritual realm. In the spirit is where the power is. The Bible says, let the weak say, I am strong. Joel 3:10. There is power when we step into the spirit realm. And whenever we try to do things on our own and figure everything out, we'll fall on our face. Sometimes it's immediate. Sometimes it takes 40 years. But we will find the dirt.
That's right.
We will find the dirt. Understand there's power in the spiritual realm. 2 Corinthians 10:4, I'll put it on reading. For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal. In other words, they're not worldly. They're not seen. They're not something that I can touch, smell, hear, or feel, or taste. They're not in this natural realm, but they're mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds. And we go to Ephesians 6:10. It talks about that. So the next few weeks, so I'm going to end here now. Thank y'all so much for coming to be a part. But I just want to say, get your inspectors on. Because sometimes there are things that you're facing now, have been facing in the last few months, and will face in the next few months, maybe a year, that it's not, it's more than what meets the eye. It's more than, there's going to be financial things that come, it's more than what meets the eye. There's going to be things happening in marriage, and in relationship with sons, daughters, relationships in the work, that it's more than meets the eye, but we have to recognize that like Elisha, and say, you know, we got the power, I see, to open my eyes, and rely on God, and connect with God, and get His help. How to get His help, we get His help through the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
We're going to talk about that. How to get His help, we get His help through worshiping in the Spirit.
Yes.
Not singing. Listen, you know, everybody that's going to church this morning is not going to worship service.
Right. That's good.
Every time I've gone to church, it probably hasn't been a worship service because I'm not perfect. Before we start talking about church, wherever, talk about this church, right here. Right here. Worship is not when we come together and we sing. Worship is when we realize that there's a God who loves us and we connect with Him. What you did this morning.
Yeah.
I felt it. I know it.
Yes.
What you did this morning. Open up the gates, open up the portal of heaven.
Yes.
That's what you did.
Yes.
But not all singing is worship.
That's right. Amen.
We're going to talk about spiritual. What did Jesus say? Man, God is spirit. And those that worship Him must worship Him as spirit and in truth. In other words, there's more than just hearing a good note. That was a good note. That was a good lick. That was a good note. No, all that's great. We want to use our gifts for God. But that is not how we tap into the power and make a difference in the spirit. When we worship, Jesus said He's looking for those who worship Him in spirit and in truth. In other words, they go past their senses. They go past what they see. They go past what they hear. And they sing a love song to something or somebody that they cannot see, that they cannot necessarily feel. And they start to worship God. And then He brings heaven. We cannot see Him, but we believe Him. And then God takes that and then He shows us because we receive our sight in the unseen realm. We're done, y'all. presence of God. I thank you all the kids that play having a blast out there. But I just want to say that God is in this house. He's doing a mighty work. And all I can say is this, you haven't seen that before.
Yeah,
it's not by might or by power, but by his spirit. How are we going to grow? How are we going to go? How is this place filled up when there's no power? I don't know. God is in this place.
Amen.
God is in. How come you all these people and nobody shows up and then all of a sudden in the season just boom and starts happening? I don't know. There's something happening behind the scenes.
Yes.
That's all I can say. But listen. Let's never say, God, show me the money. Because listen, God laughs when he's talking about when we say, show me. God's like, man, if I showed you, you'd pass out. You got to believe. And I'm going to show you. God says, I'll be a light into your path and a lamp unto your feet. He never promised to show you the end of the road. But I want to see the end of the road. I want to see just the next step. Lord, come on, give me at least a mile. I said, I'll be a light into your path and a lamp into your feet. And so in the spirit, he'll give us a glimpse. Get a glimpse. I remember I got a glimpse before we started the church. And all this stuff, like, God, how? And then I'll just be a light into your path and a lamp into your feet. And in the spirit, and I said, okay, God, I don't really know. I don't really see anything, but I just believe. And in the unseen, God has gave me my sight.
Yes, that's right.
He's given me my sight. Many of y'all, he's given me sight. How am I going to leave this family? He's giving you sight. How am I going to love this woman? How am I going to love this man? Even though he stinks, he's going to take a shower when I'm doing it. How am I going to do it? God gives you vision. He gives you sight whenever you simply believe. And we're going to talk about that. How to follow the Spirit of God. How to worship in the Spirit. How to bring a family into the Spirit together. Listen, there's nothing more intimate than worshiping in the Spirit.
Never. Amen.
Listen, we can go out and try to do everything in the world, but we're all to live together and have fun. But there's nothing more intimate than we can do family to family by prayer. Instead of worshiping together, that's the best thing. That's the most intimate thing you could ever do. You want to bring somebody, you want to suck somebody into a relationship with God, you worship with them. Now, not sing. I mean, singing may be a part of it, but not only sing. Worship in the Spirit. Go past pass the outer course, beyond the veil, into the Holy of Holies, and you trust God wholly, and you don't see nothing, and then in the unseen, God gives you sight. Let's close our eyes real quick. Father, I thank you. We receive your power. We receive